Hello, everybody. My name is Antonia Godoy, and in the next 5 minutes, I will try to give you some idea of what we are working on. So just to start, let's see the framework. We are working in computer social science. That is a file who deals with a huge amounts of data from different technological platforms, as an email network, call phone network, human transport network, Facebook, Twitter, etc., in order to understand human patterns, interaction and influences between people that interact with each other, and global and local dynamics. So in particular, we are interested in the evolution of the email network. So we analyzed data of 4 years email correspondence between 4,000 users, where nodes could be assumed to be users of the network, links are communication between them, and the width and the color of these links represent the total amount of communication sent in 1 year between them. So we observe that in time that these connections evolve, and we pretend to understand how this happens, how they evolve. So to do so, we calculate what is called the annual logarithmic growth rate. That is nothing else than for each pair of users in the network, the logarithm of the total amount of email communication sent in 1 year divided by the total amount of communication sent the year before. So we calculate this, this quantity for all the data we have of the 4 years, and we get this probability distribution. For the left part represents the distribution of those pairs that decrease the communication, and the right part represents the distribution of those pairs that increase communication. So we see that the curve is pretty symmetrical, but when we divided the data by the initial weight, that is, given that each pair of communication has, on average, a yearly, monthly, weekly, daily communication, they have different distributions, and when we plot these distributions, we observe that they are not symmetrical anymore. So there are different mechanisms regulating the increase and the decrease of the communication. And also, I would like to notice you that the positive, I mean, the right standard deviation depends on the weight, and we find that this dependency is as a power with that. The deviation depends on the power law with the initial weight. So another idea that I would like to give you is that these growths are not independent of each other. So we can have the intuition that, for instance, this small region of link here increase altogether. So to just to illustrate this and to have a better understanding on if there are some influence between closer network, neighbors, we plot the logarithm of the growth rate versus the neighboring logarithm growth rate. In this case, for the yearly communication pairs versus the neighboring also of the same kind of weight. And this is, we get on average a linear dependence. But when we look at a different kind of network, neighborhood, sorry, we observe that the slope decreases. So the influence is decreased, is smaller. So, and this is something that occurs in the whole system. So instead of looking the dependence of the yearly communication pairs, we observe the daily communication pairs, we observe again the slope is bigger than when we observe when we change again the neighbors and the slope is smaller. So there is a dependence in the closest network, and this dependence is weight dependent. And the more similar the links are, the higher is this influence. So just to conclude, say that you can follow the research of our group in the group webpage. Just thanks the organizing committee for this event, and thank you very much for listening to me.